You have to be your own advocate, because especially when you're young in this industry and first coming up, you're the best person anyway to speak out about those things and know exactly what you're comfortable with. And if that is challenged, you have to speak up.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be the case for most students going out into the field. Like, say you're graduating after this semester and you're going to be going out into this new COVID world for filmmaking. You're probably going to be on a non-union set, and you're going to have to you're probably going to have to make sure that those protocols that you want to see are there. And if they're not laid out for you, you have to ask for them and look for them.
Push for it. Yeah.
Push for it and talk to crew about what makes you feel safest, because they should be considering that. Because maybe while there is this base standard, if you think you require more, you feel unsafe on set, you need to be communicating.
Unfortunately, it still exists in this business where if you're not an advocate for yourself, there's someone who's going to take advantage of you and push you to the limit, whether it's working 20-hour days or in unsafe environments, one or the other.
And make sure that your student sets are not that, that you're listening to each other. And if somebody says something to you about COVID protocols, that you're being attentive to that, because everyone's safety matters. We want to all make sure that we're comfortable. So whatever protocols you see on sets that you feel safest on, I would apply those to your set itself. Don't think that just because it's a student film that you can sort of let things slide. You should be treating it as if it's an actual production. I would look through those SAG guidelines. While of course it's not a union set and you can't have zones, blah 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 blah, you can at least put the baseline requirements there.
There's right. pieces of things that you can do. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that another good point, that the communication practices that you learn doing this on those jobs, on the student projects that you're doing, those communication practices will help you throughout your career.